Hello, my name is Emina Jihabinti Suhemi. This video is a case brief on the Land Acquisition Act 1960, which involved two parties, Said Omar Abdulrahman Taha Al-Saghaf and another as the appellants, against the government of the states of Johor as the respondent at the Privy Council in 1975. This court case is an appeal against the decisions of the Federal Court 1975, which upheld the order of the High Court, which had dismissed the appellant's application for a declaration of acquisitions process of their land was illegal, null and void. The appellants, Said Omar Al-Saghaf and Chikuti, son of Abu Bakar, challenged the validity of the acquisitions, alleging malafide against the government of the states of Johor. Said Omar Abdulrahman Taha Al-Saghaf is the landlord of the private property with an area of 5,713 acres in the Mukim of Plantong. He had to hand over his land to the government of the state of Johor for the public purposes. The document's letter of draft layout plan for the development that has been prepared by the state planning officer of the state development officer of Johor, initially 2,000 acres of land needed for the Pasir Gudang Port project, while for the remaining 3,700 acres were allocated as special purposes. Thus, the total land area of the requirements that have been stated covering the area of some 5,700 acres. The special purposes were not the purposes that came within Section 3 of the Act or the purposes stated in the Declaration of Intended Acquisition. Under Section 8, it compulsory for the state authority to refer to in Section 7 and 3 for the Declaration of Acquisition to be published in the Gazette. Nevertheless, the appellants gave the notice of a motion on the 4th June 1972 to Said Othman Jay. It was heard and dismissed by him. For the prior proceedings on 3rd June 1974, Said Othman Jay was responsible for delivering the judgment where there were three questions that he had to determine in the application. However, the decision for the entire case was clearly on the side of the government of the state of Johor, because with the special purposes stated by the respondent in the declaration against the application plans has been acquired for shipyard purposes. Thus, with respect, the court doesn't think there is any merit in this argument, either for use as a shipyard is still used for the industrial purpose, which is specified in the first paragraph of Form D. Moreover, he assumed that people are sentimentally attached to their lands and the courts are very sympathetic to the appellants and had to dismiss the appeal with the cost. Their deposit to go to the respondent government against their tax cost. The appellants claimed the proceedings for the declaration of the intended acquisition on the acquired land were marked as vague. This is because the plan of the purpose layout of the area to be acquired supposedly state the purposes each of piece land is to be developed instead of showing the use of the area. It must be more specific since the owner has the right to his private property to be acquired. The judgment against Said Omar bin Abdulrahman Taha Al-Saghaf is affirmed, since there is no imposes of the obligation of the Act on the acquiring authority to produce an inspection plan, where the respondent has stated how the land acquired is to be zoned according to under Section 8, Subsection 3. The material or substantive part of the declaration as the conclusive evidence has been stated in Schedule Land as the purpose with specific therein. The acquisition's proceeding can be successfully challenged if malafide can be proved by the appellant. Generally, I agree with the dismissal of the judgment of the appellant's application by the Privy Council. In my opinion, whether the appellant succeed or fail to present malafide for the trial of the case in the Privy Council, the jurors and judges should reconsider the appellant's application. This is because, according to the concept of the Islamic judiciary, the court has a huge role in ensuring peace and community justice. The purpose of the establishment of the court is to provide and perform judicial services by Islamic law fairly, efficient and effective based on Islamic law. In re-perceiving, the owner of the land doesn't agree that his land is used for other purposes unless for the public purpose. And the declaration of the acquisition supposedly stated clearly and in more detail without casting any doubt on the other party. So, obviously, it against Islamic law because it doesn't get full permissions from the landlord to do any use on his land.